Allison, in the fall of 1989, the quarterback Rick Mirer arrived on campus, and 1 year later, he captured the nation's attention. I had an opportunity to sit down with him and talk about his legacy, his head coach, Lou Holtz, and Ian Book.
To walk in the building or the stadium or to see the grotto or one of the older structures, it's like, you know, deja vu.
Every time star quarterback Rick Mirer steps back on campus, it feels like 1989 all over again.
The history is what I was drawn to begin with, and what I think a lot of people are attracted to.
But unlike a lot of people, the decision to go to Notre Dame wasn't automatic. Even though the high school All-American grew up in the shadow of the Golden Dome in Goshen.
This wasn't a no-brainer. Didn't grow up Catholic. Felt like a Big Ten fan. Notre Dame hadn't been dominant in football. And all that changed, you know, right around my high school time, junior, senior year. National championship season, Lou Holtz is hitting his stride. Recruiting was on fire.
After 1 year behind Tony Rice, the hometown hero made a national name for himself when the top-ranked Irish beat then fourth-ranked Michigan to open the 1990 season. Sports Illustrated dubbed Mirer the Golden Boy. Even after two bowl victories and 29 wins as a starting quarterback, one game sticks out more than others.
I think the last game at home, Penn State game in the snow and kind of the drama around the way that ended, walking off the field with, you know, that feeling forever was worth all the blood, sweat, and tears that preceded it. And there were other games and plenty of other moments and times with the team and coaches and stuff that were great, but that was the pinnacle, and it happened to be the last one in the building.
Decades later, Mirer still keeps in touch with his Irish teammates and Coach Holtz through networking events like Lou's Labs.
I just respect most how consistent he was with the message. The pitch never, ever changed. I mean, don't ever let losing enter your mind. Don't flinch. You know, the things that all of us heard over and over and over, he did not change the plan at any point.
Almost 30 years after he graced the cover of Sports Illustrated, it's another Notre Dame quarterback that's carrying the hopes and dreams of Irish Nation on his right arm. While the sample size is much smaller compared to that of his predecessor, the expectations for Ian Book have never been bigger.
When he got his chance, the team was instantly better, and that everybody saw. I feel like there's a excitement around this guy. He's got that kind of it factor more than I did, but he's definitely got the swagger, and hopefully this year goes like it should and he backs it up and does it again.
Mirer spent 11 seasons in the NFL and stepped away from the game in 2004. But just 4 years later, he found himself quarterbacking another team.
The wine thing was purely because we were in California and I needed something to work on.
In 2008, he set his sights on Mirer Wines, a small boutique winery in the heart of wine country in Sonoma County, California.
One thing led to another. With no question, and it just was like an exercise in marketing and network, and you know, 10 years have gone by and it's been like that.
His clientele, exclusive. His batches, limited. But believe it or not, the perfect pour turns out to be a tougher task than throwing the pigskin.
I think the growing the grapes part is probably harder. The way I look at the quarterback part, when you're 18 to 22, you don't even feel pressure, really. Farming and business depend on other people doing their job. It's similar to football, but there's certain things you just can't control. I miss the quarterbacking part because it ends. Like, that's when that day ends, you're not doing that anymore. So I'm trying to figure out the next part and make that simpler than it's been.
The Golden Boy entering a golden age, cherishing every moment like it's 1989 all over again.
You know, what's fun is that you start over with the young kids who don't know anything about you, and it's their dad or mom that remembers, and it's just a chance to, you know, shake hands with somebody that they've heard and watched for a long time.
Told me one of the best parts of his life now is just being dad. Of course, his son Morrison is on the lacrosse team here and scored in the postseason just a year ago. His other son Oliver, believe it or not, is Michigan bound next year. Great to sit down with the Irish legend here 30 years later. Of course, his wines can be found at the Morrison on campus. Allison, we'll send it back to you.